When it comes to international rivalries on the biggest stage, Brazil versus Argentina is certainly special. It isn't just a strive for success at the highest level type of rivalry, there's more to it. And so with the Copa America 2021 final just around the corner, it's about time we explored what fuels this rivalry. Hi there, I'm Adrian and welcome to Rabona TV. For this video, I will have some help from my friends Fede and Filippo, aka Tactical Manager. I've linked to their channels below, so do be sure to check them out. They were a massive help, and hearing from actual Brazilians and Argentinians and their experience with the rivalry was a lot of fun. And speaking of Brazil, Argentina, Copa America, Primera División, or Campeonato Brasileiro, no matter which tournament you're following this summer, or which league you follow during the regular season, our kind sponsors for this video, OneFootball, have got you covered with their free app linked below. OneFootball provides you with the best app for all things football this summer, including the fastest breaking news, the ability to track the clubs and countries you care about for a customized news feed, live updated match tickers for when you're on the go, videos, and so much more. So, use the link in the description for a free download on iOS or Android. Stay up to date on all things football throughout Euro 2020 or Copa America and the club football season, and you'll help out an independent creator like me as well. Thank you, OneFootball, and let's get into this Roots of the Rivalry, if you will, international edition. Now, of course, there are always some cultural differences between countries, which we will get into later with Fede. And some even go as far as to pointing out that the territory battles between Argentina, Uruguay, and Brazil over the Rio de la Plata basin contribute to the rivalry between these countries, that being sort of an initial flashpoint. More on that rivalry later, but in footballing terms, it all started back in 1914. Julio Argentino Roca was a former president of Argentina, but in the 1910s, he was Argentina's ambassador to Brazil. And in order to build up a sporting relationship with Brazil, and in order for football to hopefully build in popularity on the continent, he put forth that there should be an annual cup contested between the two nations. This cup would go on to be called the Roca Cup, and would first be contested in 1914. But with some harsh weather conditions leading to delays in Brazil's trip to Buenos Aires for the first Roca Cup match, the first edition of such was postponed by a week, and a friendly was instead played between Brazil and Argentina. In their first ever meeting, Argentina won 3-0, but a week later, when the Roca Cup match went ahead, Brazil won 1-0. Argentina with the first win ever between the two, Brazil with the first competitive win, if you will. This tournament would be held until the 70s, with Brazil winning it 8 times and Argentina winning it 4 times. While it's no longer held, it has a successor in the Superclásico de las Américas, which is a friendly between Brazil and Argentina that is held annually, though it's played over one leg as opposed to the two-legged version of the past. But I'd say it's high time we speak to an Argentinian and a Brazilian to get their take on it all and look ahead to the Copa America final. So, as you know, for this video, I called upon Fede. He has his own YouTube channel that I've linked below, while he also works for Oh My Goal, which you're surely familiar with, and is an encyclopedia of Argentinian football knowledge. Filippo, you may know him as Tactical Manager. He too has a great YouTube channel producing plenty of content on the US men's national team, but he was born and raised in Brazil and hasn't missed a Seleção match in years. So, let's go.
There's always been a rivalry between countries among the population. As someone that lived in Brazil for a while, I've seen that in the 2014 World Cup, I saw it in front of me.
With Brazil, it's entirely a football rivalry because we are neighbors, but we are very different. We are so, so different. Brazil is one of the few countries in South America that doesn't speak Spanish as their main language. They have a completely Argentina v Brazil, it's a thing about identity, I think, if you take it outside from football, because a big part of our identity is football. We live and we breathe and we feel football very intensely, very differently to what it's like here in Europe. As an ideology or a personal identity thing, we are very different with Brazilians. Argentinians and Brazilians, we are very different. They are a joyful nation, you know, and they have this life that embraces dance and partying and being on the beach and that whole real vibe. You can like hear the music when you talk about Brazilians, you know. I think about Ronaldinho smiling and all this, and we Argentinians are not about that.
How would you expand on that to say that you're a sufferer? Would you say that you're more serious or pessimistic or something like that?
Both. Like Brazilian music is all about bossa and samba and, you know, carnival and blah blah blah. Very, very joyful, very, very up. Our music is tango. It's a nostalgic music. It's songs about things that have gone, or things that you have lost, or sorrows that you have, you know? Nowadays, both Brazilians and Argentinians, we have much of the same woes. The way we approach life is a bit different. I think we are definitely more pessimistic.
Yeah, that's interesting to hear that about the tango as a way of sort of illustrating that, because it's I sort of liken it to Portuguese fado music, which you're maybe familiar with, which is all about longing and, you know, missing lovers that went out to sea and never returned and stuff like that. So it's interesting hearing that.
I think it comes down to being the two dominant forces in the region and at some point even in the world, right? Brazil and Argentina, from the soccer world. So there's that factor.
How much of a role do you think that Pelé and Maradona play in this rivalry? Because, you know, it's the two players that people always speak about as the best of all time. So I'm sure that it plays some sort of role in this rivalry as well.
Well, yeah, and I think that's the heart of the rivalry. Because, of course, being neighbors, feeling basically the same for football, having been playing against each other for the past 100 years or so, there's obviously a rivalry there. But when you take into account, when you go to the statistics or you go to the trophies and this and that, there's an undeniable fact, which is that Brazil has 5 World Cups. We have 2. Not for the lack of trying, of course. We've been basically to the same amount of finals. Brazil only lost 1, we've lost 3. In Copa America terms, we're definitely better than them. So is Uruguay. Pelé and Maradona, their rivalry and their very different personalities, they are how we approach this rivalry. When I say we, I say Argentinians, you know?
Yeah, there's always been a dispute there in Brazil and Argentina. Who's better, Pelé or Diego? They've always said that. And obviously from Brazil, we're always going to say Pelé. And we're going to say Pelé has 3 World Cups, 1. Argentina alone has 2. Maradona didn't even play on one of them in 1978. He wasn't even there. So they play a big role in that, and it's part of the rivalry as well. Unfortunately, we didn't have anyone to match with Messi right now. We thought Neymar would be that guy, and as good as Neymar is, and not being biased, obviously, Messi is in a different level. So unfortunately, we didn't have that now. But yeah, Maradona and Pelé played a ginormous role right there. And then it goes on even to the club level in the Libertadores disputes of Brazilians and Argentines.
I would love for our club form to translate over to a national team, because at club level, we own Brazil. We own it, like Argentinian teams, especially in the past 15 years.
How do you feel about this Argentina side in comparison to those of the past? You know, how do you feel? Do you feel like they're turning a corner from where they were at, let's say, the 2018 World Cup?
We don't have the best available coach in Argentina. I think that's the biggest letdown I have right now, because 2018 was such a terrible World Cup. It was so bad in terms of everything. Everything that led to that World Cup was a disaster. There are problems with the team. Like, we have seen the same cycle over and over again. We get a first 25 very, very, very solid minutes in the beginning. Then we score, and then we start dropping level. We get back, pushed back by the rival. We lose the ball, and we're always very close to losing, but never lose.
Going back to 2 years ago, I wouldn't even say there's not that many differences in regards. This team seems much more serious after the 2018 World Cup. But ever since we lost the World Cup in 2018, we haven't lost a competitive match, right? We played the Copa America in 2019. We won undefeated without Neymar. Neymar wasn't there. He was injured at the time. The Comembol qualifiers, Brazil has been rolling through every single nation. And now we come into this game, to this Copa America, which we're undefeated once again. We continue to be somewhat dominant. People will question Brazil here and there. But the thing with Brazil that people don't understand is this team, they push it when they need it. If they get a 1-0 lead, they go easy in the game. If they tie, they go and push it. And that's why Brazil has been able to win games regardless, even against Colombia. And people will claim the VAR, it's all nonsense. Brazil is the most dominant team. You look at the starting lineup, the roster, it's the best team.
Brazil have strolled around the Copa America. They are doing things at their own pace. Neymar is having fun. From a point of view that's closer to the heart and to what my feelings have been throughout the Copa America and to this team and to Messi, yeah, we're gonna win this. We're gonna win this. Brazil have all the pressure, we have none. Messi is playing at his best level with Argentina, I would say. The others are doing what they have to do. This is our best shot at winning against Brazil. And honestly, of course I want to win against Brazil, but the only thing I want right now is for Messi to lift the Copa America.
Nervous, always, because it's Brazil and Argentina. And I learned to, even though Brazil has outplayed Argentina in the past 20 years or so, I learned to not underestimate Argentina. And Argentina has a player that I love bantering all Argentinian players. I'll banter Higuain, Lautaro Martinez. Higuain's not there now. Aguero, everyone. I won't banter Messi. So I have huge respect for Messi, and he is one of the best players of all time. And I learned to not underestimate Messi as well.
You almost want Messi to win it more than Argentina in general to win this trophy, in a sense, I guess.
Yeah, completely, completely. Because I want to win it. I want to celebrate the title. I want to be done with that and to lift the curse from Argentina, because we have been to... This is going to be our third Copa America final in the past 6 years, if I'm not mistaken. It's a lot. And we've lost to Chile twice. Who does that? Chile had never won anything and we lost twice.
You know, it's unfortunate that there will be fans at this final, but I can imagine how sweet it would be for Argentina, not only for Messi to win this trophy, but for Argentina to win this trophy in Brazil as well. Fans or not, that would be a very, very tasty idea, wouldn't it?
Yeah, yeah. If there were fans at the Maracanã, I could guarantee 100% we're going to win this. They don't want us to believe that, but Brazil, they choke. On the biggest scenarios, they choke. Especially at home.
The 7-1 comes to mind, doesn't it?
Yeah, and the 1950 World Cup lost to Uruguay. Like, the trophy already had the name of Brazil on it.
I think we're the favorites against Argentina. So it all comes down to that matchup, Casemiro on Messi. I think Neymar will deliver. He'll get it done. Doesn't mean he'll score a goal or anything, but he'll be dangerous. So I think the key is that it's Casemiro and Messi. See if Casemiro can stop Messi like he's done on Real Madrid days. Besides that, I don't know what to expect. Crazy game. That's what I expect.
So it's certainly finally poised. As Argentina come into this on a 19-match unbeaten run, their last loss was actually against Brazil. Brazil themselves are on a lengthy unbeaten run as well. Messi would love to get a trophy, and to get it on Brazilian soil would be all the more chef kiss sweet for him. Well, it would be Brazil's pleasure to beat their neighbors and rivals in a final once again, just as they did back in 2007, and deny Messi of that trophy. And if you want to take in this match with some friends, by the way, Filippo, our tactical manager, will be doing a watch-along on his channel, Tactical Manager TV, so do be sure to check that. If I can swing it, I may make a guest appearance as well. So, I thank you guys for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, do leave a like and subscribe if you're new around here. My name's Adrian, this is Rabona TV, and enjoy the final. Take care.